Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today I wanted to do a quick video in regards to citizen eco drives and the misconceptions of the eco drive that I personally have had, and I'm sure some of you have as well. So when you have a citizen eco drive, you probably assume that, okay, this is a watch that is driven by sunlight and other natural lights. Actually even unnatural lights, and therefore does not need a battery and will last you forever. And that is so far from the truth. So as you can see here, the hand is ticking every two ticks, as you can see there. That means that the battery is wearing out. I tried charging this for a pretty long while and still no improvement. So what I did was opened up the back and realized that there is indeed a battery. So Average Joe learned a lesson today in regards to the Citizen Eco Drive. Now, maybe in the comments below, you guys can tell me what the advantages of having an Eco Drive is, but quite honestly, I've had this watch for a couple years, and it doesn't mean that this watch is only a couple years old. I mean, this was a watch that I purchased as a floor model from a store. So I don't know how long it has been running, but is there truly an advantage to having an eco drive as opposed to just a regular quartz? That's something that I would really like to dive into in the comment section below. So let's get into what is going on when we open up the eco drive. So this video could also help those that have no idea how to open up a case even. So this will definitely serve you as well. So again, we take a look at the second hand and it is ticking every 2 seconds. Okay. Now we pull the crown out, as you can see, and it stops the movement, just like any quartz movement. Okay. So let's flip it to the back. And as you can see, it is a citizen eco drive. Okay, so we take our handy case back opening tool here. This is a tool that you can find at any, pretty much Amazon is one, eBay, but very cheap, under $5. And what you do is you take a look at the notches that you see here every so often, and then what you're going to do is you're going to bring these pins in or out depending on how wide these it is from notch to notch, as you can see here. Once you have it in place to where it's very comfortable for you to then twist counterclockwise, you can then open the case up. And I'm gonna just need it with some a little bit more, and you just keep turning until this case will come off, revealing what is going on back here. Okay. There we go. And as you can see, it's got the waterproofing gasket on the outside. They recommend changing that each time you change the battery. All right. So what do we got going on here? As you can see, we have a Panasonic battery right there. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the battery out and we're going to see, is there anything different about this battery? It looks like a standard watch battery. Let's take a look. So we're just going to pop it out, just like that. And I'm gonna take, pardon me as I take my tweezers here, and we're going to explore what this battery actually looks like. So let's take this away and see if we can see. Ah, there we go. Take a look at that. I just lost it, sorry. Let me try to get you guys a better view of what this battery really looks like. This is really Not the easiest thing in the world to do. I'm sorry about that. So take a look at there. As you can see, very interestingly, there's actually something that is connected to that battery, which indeed, I guess, charges the battery. Now that's something interesting. I've never actually seen that before. So we take a look inside the watch here, and you'll see, and maybe I can actually shine, let's see if we can get a good light here. Can you see right there inside this canal? You can see where the battery will be charged. So the connection on this extra piece on the battery, I'm going to show you again. That piece that sticks out of the battery, let's take this out of the way for a second. There we go. You see that piece that sticks out? That actually fits into there just like that. So you have to line it up properly, and that actually charges the battery when you put it under sunlight. So the part that I, and I think many others, well, check this out. This is pretty interesting. Check this out. I actually have the battery out. Check this out. I'm actually learning something as we do this, but the battery is out completely, and yet the watch is still ticking. How cool is that? Now that is cool. So I'm going to continue to charge this even more. Maybe it needs even more of a charge. Because to me, that's not necessarily telling me I need a new battery if the battery is out and it's still performing that way. So I know that, you know, this thing needs to be charged and whatnot, and maybe it just needs a good full charge. So I will check back in the next video to show you exactly what has transpired in regards to me giving this more light, and I'll get back to you. But I will indeed put the battery back in, and we'll have it charged, and then I'll make another video. So until then, I learned something along with you real time about the Citizen EcoDrive. Never knew what was in the back of these things. And to be quite honest with you, I had no idea that this thing could run without the battery. So I'm going to charge this up even more, and then I'll get back to you on what I find out. And as you can see, it's still running. Amazing. All right. I'll see you guys shortly. Have a good day.